This video is going to serve as an introduction to normalizing a wave function. So recall that we interpret the modulus square of the wave function, that is, psi star times psi, as defining the probability distribution for finding the particle at some position x. Now, because we believe that particle should exist somewhere, we are guaranteed to find that particle if we look everywhere. So in other words, if we sum up the probabilities for finding it at every possible position x, they should sum up to 100% chance of finding the particle, or a probability of 1. So normalizing a wave function just means multiplying it by a constant to ensure that the sum of those probabilities for finding the particle do in fact equal 1. So mathematically, this means integrating psi star psi over all space, and when we do so, we ought to obtain 1. To see a pictorial example, consider the particle in a box. And this is the n equals 2 state for the particle in the box, and for simplicity, I've chosen the box length of l equals 1, which makes the l from our wave functions disappear. And so an unnormalized version of the wave function might be like this, where it's just psi of x is equal to sine 2 pi x. A normalized one ends up having a factor of a square root of 2 in front of it. I've plotted those two functions here, and you can see the difference. The shape is the same for the two wave functions. The only difference is the height, or the amplitude, of the wave function, and you can see it's somewhat higher for the normalized one. And if you go ahead and evaluate the integral of psi star psi over the entire length of the box, if you do it for the red unnormalized curve, you'll find that it sums to 1/2, whereas if we do it for the green curve, it sums to 1. So in the unnormalized case, and that corresponds to having an unphysical distribution because it's not properly normalized. It would say that there's only a 50% chance of finding the particle somewhere in the box, but we know it has to be 100% chance. So the process of normalizing it is just multiplying it by a constant that ensures that when we do that integration over the entire box, we're guaranteed to find the particle, that is, with 100% probability. So how do we actually do this in practice? Well, the basic idea is you want to evaluate this integral. You want to take your wave function, multiply it by its complex conjugate, and integrate over all space, and ensure that that integral is equal to 1. So we're going to look at this in two ways. First, we're going to take in a case where we're just going to check if this equation is true, for an example. And then, in the second case, if not, we're going to show how we can solve for the constant necessary to multiply the wave function with in order to make this expression true. So let's return to the n equals 2 state for the particle in a box of length L that we looked at a couple slides ago. So the unnormalized wave function has this form, psi of x equals sine 2 pi x. So we're going to go ahead and check if this is normalized. So we're going to plug that psi into our general expression for psi star psi integrated over all space. So you can see I've plugged in psi in both places here. Now, because this wave function is real, the complex conjugate is exactly the same as the normal wave function. And then for the particle in the box, we also don't have to really integrate over all space because we know there's zero chance of finding the particle outside the box because of the infinite potential out there. So therefore, we only need to integrate over the length of the box itself, which in this case goes from 0 to 1 because it's a box length of 1. And so now we just go ahead and do this integral, multiply these together, do our change of variables, and use a table of integrals to solve. And in the end, you should find that this integral is equal to 1/2, as I said a couple of slides ago. So in other words, this wave function is not normalized because the sum of the probabilities does not equal 1. If we want to normalize this, we're going to go ahead and take this wave function and we're going to multiply it by a constant a in front. That's going to be a times sine 2 pi x. And now we want to try and find what value of a makes this wave function normalized. That is, that makes this integral here equal to 1. And so we're going to do the same basic procedure we did before. We're going to plug in this wave function, this time with the constant a in front of it, into our psi star psi expression. We're going to integrate over the same limits, the length of the box. Go ahead and evaluate this integral, and when you do so, you should get that it is equal to a squared over 2. Now, if it's normalized, this integral should be equal to 1. And so this gives us an expression right here that we can use to solve for the value of a that makes this wave function normalized. So if a squared over 2 is supposed to be equal to 1, that implies that a is equal to the square root of 2. And so in other words, our normalized wave function is simply the square root of 2 times sine 2 pi x. Now, if you'd like a little exercise at home, you can go ahead and plug this wave function, square root of 2 times sine 2 pi over x, back into our original expression and show that you do in fact get that this wave function is equal, that this normalization integral is equal to 1. Now, all right, let's do one more example. We'll talk about this in chapter 4, but it turns out that you can actually have other wave functions for a particle inside a box that are not just the sine n pi x over l wave functions. And so one potential wave function might be something like this, psi of x equals x times l minus x for a particle in a box of length l. And so let's go ahead and normalize this wave function. I'm go ahead and pause the video and try and work this out, and then hit play again when you're ready to see the solution. All right, we're going to go ahead and normalize this. So again, we're going to set up the same normalization integral, psi star psi, integrate over all space. In this case, all space means the whole length of the box from 0 to L. I'm plugging in psi star and psi. Notice I put a constant A in front of each. That's the constant we're going to be solving for in order to normalize this. And now we're going to go ahead and carry out this integration. So when I multiply those out, I get A squared times the integral from 0 to L of x squared times L minus x quantity squared dx. Multiply all that out, do the integral, evaluate the integral, and you end up with a squared times l to the fifth over 30. And then if this is normalized, that quantity should be equal to 1. So we can go ahead and solve for a, and what we find is that a is equal to square root of 30 over l to the fifth. And so our normalized wave function is psi of x equals square root of 30 over l to the fifth times x times l minus x. Hopefully this video helped you figure out how to do normalization. If not, please seek out me or the TA for further help.